Like the desert needs the rain.
Every ocean needs the stream.
I need you like
every morning needs the sun.
I need you, Lord.
You are my only one.
Here is my heart. I give it, Lord, to you. And here is my life. I lay it before you. Tell me, where else would I go? And what else would I do? If I did.
Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We give God all the glory. We thank God for the word that came forth. And I decree and I declare that Jesus Christ is Lord over every situation. For those who have called in for prayer, God meets you at the point of your need. Praise the Lord. We bless God for the word. Today is the day that the Lord has made. Another day, another time where we can come before the throne room of grace and say, Abba, Father. We say thank you, God, for this new day, for you made this day, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. Whatever situations, they are not too big for God to handle them and to fix them and to restore you. So trust God where you don't see him. God is spirit. Praise the name of the Lord.
Oh.
My Lord,
like
the desert needs the rain.
Praise the name of the Lord. This is Choice Gospel Radio on 92.9 FM. It's your life, your salvation, and your choice. This morning, we are in the program Salvation and Revelation, brought to you by Choice Gospel Radio, geared so that we'll all make it into God's kingdom. We will enjoy the benefits of our salvation and work, persevere to the end, to make it into heaven, to see our King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Also to expound the word and teach us so that we will grow in the things of God. So God bless you this morning. And even as we go into the throne room of grace, before we call, God has already answered. So today we're going to trust him and believe that he is God over all things. Praise the name of the Lord. Father, we say thank you for another opportunity whereby, O God, we have a new lease in life, another day, O God. We say thank you, O God, for your mercies. Thank you for your grace. Thank you, O God, for your loving kindness, O God. Thank you, O God, because you are God eternal, O God. And Father, you never change, O God. We say thank you, O God, Father, for your unconditional love that you have given to your children, O God. We say thank you for this morning for salvation through Jesus Christ. We thank you for the power in the Lord Jesus Christ's blood, O God. We say thank you, O God, Lord Jesus, for dying, O God, for our sins. But we say thank you, Abba, Father, O God, God Almighty, for sending your Son Jesus to die for us. We don't take it for granted. We say thank you, Lord, from the bottom of our hearts, that we have the divine privilege, another opportunity whereby we can come in your presence. No one come to the Father but through you, Jesus Christ. And we say thank you for access to your Son, Lord Father. I bless you, O God, for your Holy Spirit. O God, without your Spirit, we cannot do anything, O God. You said, O God, who comes to God must believe first that you are God, and you reward those who diligently seek you, O God. But Father, you said the Spirit of you, O God, the Spirit of the living God, draw souls, O God, to your kingdom, Lord Father. And that Holy Spirit, that very blessed Holy Spirit, give honor and glory and praise, O God, and all the love to Jesus Christ of Nazareth. All the attention, O God, goes to you, Jesus, because we love you, O God. So Holy Spirit, give glory to the Son of God on this day in the name of Jesus. We say thank you, O God. We bless you, O God. We worship you, O God. We say thank you, O God, for Lord God, you are our all in all. We have no other friend but you, Lord Jesus. There's no other friend that stay closer than a brother but you, Lord Jesus. You said in your word, you shall never leave us nor forsake us, O God. And we thank you, O God, for your word. Hebrews 13 verse 5 says, you shall never leave us, never forsake us. And we bless you for your word. We thank you for that blessed promise that no matter what we are going through, Lord Father, you are on our side. You are with us, Lord God. And Father, we would not forsake you, O God, in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord God, I ask you to bless this day, O God. Bless each one, O God, that comes, O God, Father, to minister your word today, O God. The word that has already gone forth, O God. Father, Lord God, I decree and I declare, O God, that, Father, every, O God, person, O God, every minister of God, who, O God, Father, takes this, O God, this mic, O God, to speak your word, O God, that everything will be done in order and in decency according to your word. Nothing missing, nothing added in the name of Jesus. I ask you, O God, Father, Lord God, to send your anointing, the anointing of your Holy Spirit, O God. We need your anointing, O God. We need your power, the power of the Holy Spirit, to fill us afresh, O God. I ask you, O God, Father, Lord God, that the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be acceptable unto you, my God, my Savior, and my Redeemer. I ask you, O God, Father, to anoint each one that's coming on, O God, air today, O God, to bring your word. O God, that it will come with clarity, with conviction, with strength, O God, from your Holy Spirit, O God, that whatever, O God, is spoken, O God, will bring change, permanent change to the lives of your people, that lives will be saved and changed for eternity. In Jesus' name, I pray, amen and amen. So it is, and so it shall be. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
In every way, in every day, I need you.
I need you. Hey,
hey. In every way, in every day, I need you.
I need you.
In every way, I need you.
Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We need him. We need the Lord. Hallelujah. We need him. We need him. And today, if you need Jesus Christ of Nazareth, if you don't know you need him, know today that you need a Savior. We cannot save ourselves. Amen. So we need a Savior. And his name is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. No one comes to the Father. He's the way, the truth, and the life. Praise the name of the Lord. And today, if you do not know him as Lord and Savior, I decree and I declare that salvation for your soul. Today is the day of salvation, that your soul will be saved in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Father, Lord God, that a wonderful work of salvation, that work that was done on the cross by Jesus Christ, would not miss you, that you would accept him as your Lord and Savior. For this is the sole purpose of our existence, to make it into eternity, that we might be saved. If we endure to the end, we will be saved. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. For so, Father, Lord God, for that one who do not know you as Lord and Savior, I ask you, O God, to touch, O God, deliver, set free, O God, that one today who have cried out to you, O God, Father, Lord God, who speaking to you, O God, without knowing you yet, O God, but they believe that you, O God, has the answers to every situation. And because of that childlike trust, O God, I decree and I declare that today, Lord God, as they submit their heart to you today, that it will not be tomorrow, but today, O God, your life will be changed today for eternity, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. It's not by might, it's not even by power, but it's only by your Spirit. So Holy Spirit, draw someone into your kingdom today. Draw souls into your kingdom today, O God. And I say thank you in advance, O God. You said before we call, you have already answered, O God. So I thank you, O God, for answered prayers, that someone today, or lives today, will be changed for eternity. That, O God, Father, your people will come up higher with you, O God. O God, begin with me, O God, that we'll come up higher, O God, and live a life that is pleasing to you, and that we'll all make it into your kingdom together when you come to take, O God, your people home, to take your church home. A church without spots nor wrinkle, O God. A perfect church. O God, Father, bring us to the state of perfection, O God, according to your word. Not by might, nor by power, but, O God, do it by the power of your Holy Spirit. And we say thank you, O God, for doing it. So it is, and so it shall be. Amen, amen. The Bible said we shall decree a thing and it shall come to pass. So I decree it and it will come to pass. You all listening this morning, know that salvation is yours as you submit your heart to Jesus Christ and say, yes, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, and I give him my heart as the key will be to, from this day forward, the king of my life, the head of my life, and everything else in my life, they are additions. And I put him first place in my life. I ask him to forgive me all my sins, because we are all sinners, but we can be saved by the grace of God if we submit our hearts to him and make a decision to not do the things that we used to do. We wouldn't do them no more. And this is what salvation is about: repentance, changing, and having a remorse that you have you know that you displease God. But because of his shed blood on the cross, Jesus died. He came as a mediator between you and your God to stand in the gap, so that this holy God, who, oh God, cannot tolerate sin, can commune with you through the presence of Jesus Christ in your life. The power of the Holy Spirit will draw you today in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ is Lord. God is a good God, amen? And today, he wants you to know that he is eternal, amen? He is everlasting. He is omnipresent. He's always with us. He will never leave you. He will never forsake you. You just have to believe that through your storms, through your trials, God is with you. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Again, pleasant good morning to all in Radio Land. This is truly the day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. And the Bible says to pray without ceasing. We are in times when we need to pray more. We need to stay in the Word more. We need to thank God more. We need to worship him more. We need to praise him more. We need to live each day as if it's the last day that we are living, because there are so many changes that's going on in the world today, over in nations. You know, we see things that are written in the Word of God. You know, sometimes we think it's not going to come to pass because it's business as usual. But signs of the times are everywhere. Men has gotten more violent. Men has their own imagination of what is right and what is wrong. There's no spiritual absolutes. Men have hearts are fainting because of fear. We see, you know, people are giving up because of the circumstances and situations, forgetting that there is a God Almighty, that there is a God who is watching over all the earth. There is a God who the earth is his footstool. Amen. So we are under his authority, and he is our guide. He is our counsel. He is our deliverer. He is our strength, and he is our salvation. Amen. And there is no other God like Jehovah. We have to trust in that God, but we have to remember in all our trust in that God is a holy God, and he does not change his word because we have changed our plans. He does not change his word because we have adopted a different gestalt, a different way of looking at things. Amen. And you know, we the imagination of man is have become consistently like always wicked. Things that the wicked devices are, we've seen it everywhere. When you put the news on, the things that are happening, it's unbelievable. But we must hold on and put our total trust in God. Amen. God is spirit, and he said, and his truth, his life. He said, they that worship him, it's a requirement. We must worship him in spirit and in truth. Amen. And we must trust him by faith. It is by faith we come to God. The Bible says that no one comes to the Father unless the Spirit draws him. Amen. And we must know that as the Spirit of the Lord draws us to him, that we must come, and we must come in and submit our lives to him and know that he is God. It is not we who made ourselves. He made us, and he wants us to know that today, that we have an accountability for souls, because he has placed before us life and death. And he says, I have given you power of life and death in your mouth. So he gave us an authority, but he also gave us the tool to take that authority, which is the word of God. Amen. The tool of the word and the ability, which is our mouth, to speak a thing, and the authority to watch it come to pass is given to us by God. And if we cease to take that opportunity to ask Christ into our lives, He has given us, you know, a choice, you know, to make. He did not make it for us. He said, I set before you life and death. These things are, when something is set, it's there. It's not going to move. He's setting before you life. He have set it. And death. They both are in your presence. And you can choose to live in eternity. And you can choose to follow after the ways of God. Or you can choose to decide, I'm going to do my own way of thinking. I'm gonna you know, live like anyhow that I choose to live. Because I am my own boss. I do it my way instead of doing it God's way. And if you decide to do it your way, then you are not in line with God's way. And that means that Satan has a hold of your life. Amen. Because it's either God's way or the way of Satan, the way of the enemy. Yes, there is a God, and yes, there is a Satan. Amen. We know when we went to school, for those who have been to school, when we do physics and chemistry, there are certain laws that you know, govern certain principles. And one of the things is that to every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. Amen. So we see that in terms of natural life, but in spiritual life, there is God and there is Satan. There is heaven and there is hell. There is life and there is death. Amen. He said to you this morning, I set before you life and death. Choose life. He gave us the answer in which choice we should make. And if you do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, and you neglect to make the choice that He has instructed us to make, then you are sealing your own destiny and deciding that I want to stay in the situation I am in. I don't care if my soul go to heaven or hell, because I am going to do it my way and see what happens. Well, what's going to happen in the end result? He says that at the end, it's appointed unto man just one time to die, and after death there's judgment. You will not be able to stand before God and say, guess what, Father? You know, I didn't do this because everybody else was thinking this way, or everybody else was doing it this way. Amen. He has said certain things in this word. He said, I am a jealous God. Do not have no gods before me. God said it. He said His word is forever settled in heaven. He said His word will not come back to Him empty, void, but will accomplish what He sent it out to do. He said that He's coming again to judge the living and the dead. You know, He said those who remain will be caught up to meet Him in the air. Those who are asleep, those who died and in the grave, they are sleeping, and they would be caught up first. They would rise first, and those we who will remain will be caught up. That's what He said. This is word is financial, is forever settled in heaven. Amen. He said He has set before you life and death. Choose life. Amen. He said there's power in the name of Jesus. Yes, there's power. Many times we look for power, you know, in maybe things that we say, okay, then I need educational power. That's good. You need to educate yourself. Some of them we need social power. You need to be able to affect change in society to make sure that things go the right way, so you can make a stand for something. The Bible says, if you don't stand for nothing, you fall for anything. Not the Bible, but there's a saying, I would say. But if you don't make that decision, just as you made a decision for Christ do not make a decision for Christ, then when you don't make the decision for Christ, it opens you up to fall for anything. Amen. Because many false prophets and teachers are gone out into the world to possibly deceive even the very elect. I'm talking about those whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life, those who have received Jesus Christ because they chose Him as their Lord and Savior. Yes, Satan wants to deceive them, and he wants to get them out of the kingdom. So you who are already outside of the kingdom, for someone who is not saved, I'm speaking to someone in love, that God is love, and He loves you this much, that He waited on you this long for you to say, yes, I surrender all. He has shown you so many times that, you know, He is real. He manifested Himself to you so many times by showing up in your life when you thought all failed you, but still there's some kingdoms in your life that you will not let go of. There are certain things that you say, oh, you know what? I want to do this. Yes, I believe this part of the Bible, but you know, I'm not going to live by this one because this one does not suit my lifestyle. God will not care about your lifestyle. God cares about your holiness, that you are in right standing with him through his son, Jesus Christ. And the only way we can be in right standing with our Father is through Jesus Christ and through accepting him as the Lord and Savior. He said if we confess with our mouth, believe in our heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, he'll come into our heart and he will live there. We have created us, not we ourselves. Now we see men, women, even children are changing themselves to become what they choose to be. Amen. God has created you after his own image and his own likeness. But now we see there is no spiritual absolute. You know, we see we are living in a time where, you know, things are just, you know, everybody's doing what everybody thinks is right in their own sight. Amen. It was in the beginning, so shall it be in the end. Amen. But we have to remember that God would never change. Never changes. It does not change. So we have to go back to the Word of God. See what the Word of God says and live what the Word of God said. Don't become a hearer of the Word, but become a doer of the Word. Shall we pray? Father, we say thank you for your word, O God. We say thank you for your gift of salvation, O God. Father, there is someone who do not know you as Lord and Savior, or someone who gave their life to you but has taken it back because of the pressures of life, because of the trials, because of the disappointments, because of the challenges of life, that they have become, O Lord, complacent or, you know, just, you know, giving up. I ask you, O God, Father, to encourage that one today, that you have never left them. You have never forsaken them, O God, that you are with them and you said you will be with them even unto the end, O God. Father, O God, what you have done for others, you'll do it for your child this morning in the name of Jesus. As that one say, yes, Lord, I still believe in you. I know that you are real in my life. And yes, I have not been in the place that you want me to be. But today, I make a decision to come back to you, my Abba Father, the one who I know loved me unconditionally. I rededicate myself to you. I give my heart back to you. And I would not take it back anymore. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. For that one who do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, but they know about you, Lord, because you have manifested yourself so many times, oh God, in so many ways. I ask you, Lord God, to save that one this morning in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare, oh God, that you will save that one to the uttermost. Write that name in heaven as that one make that confession of faith that Jesus Christ is Lord and Savior. Jesus Christ is the only way, the truth, and the life. You said if we confess with our mouth and believe in our heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, that you'll come into that heart and you'll live there forever. You'll send your Holy Spirit to take residence in that life. And you, O God, Father, Lord God, will dwell with that one. You'll be their comforter in the form of your Holy Spirit. Three persons, one God. You have sent your Son. And you have given us your spirit when we give our heart to you, O God. So as that one says, yes, I believe that Jesus Christ is truly the Son of God. As that one make that confession, I decree and I declare that Lord Father, Lord God, today your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life because you say, yes, Jesus Christ is Lord. And now you go further and ask him to forgive you for all your sins. Father, Lord God, we have sinned in thoughts, in words, in deeds. And so many times, oh God, we have failed you, oh God. For that one who have, oh God, done things that, oh God, Father, Lord God, displease you. You have forgiven me. And I know the same God, Jehovah, God Almighty, has the same power to forgive you because he does not change. So I decree and I declare, as you confess your sins to that, my Father, that Lord, through Jesus Christ shed blood, all those sins are forgiven in the name of Jesus. I believe by faith, O God, that as you say, yes, Lord, I trust you and I believe by faith. I take you at your word and I believe you have forgiven all my sins. You have given me a clean record today. I repent of my sins. I'm not going to do the things that I used to do anymore. I'm not going to think the way I thought before today. Today I have a new walk with you. I repent. I'm going to follow after your word. Give me strength by the power of your Holy Spirit to change my life for eternity. I believe by faith that my name is written in your Lamb's book of life, never to be erased. I shall not lose my place in heaven because I believe that you have saved me to the uttermost. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen and amen. Jesus Christ is the Lord. And today, if you have said this prayer, or you have come in agreement, or you said it in your own way, whatever, however you wanted to speak to your God, but you ask him to come into your heart, you ask him to forgive you your sins, you ask him to cleanse you from all unrighteousness, you ask him today to write your name in his book of life, that you believe by faith that he has written your name in this book of life, and you know in your heart that the things you used to do, there's a change. You do not want to do them anymore. I decree and I declare that salvation is yours by the power of the Holy Spirit. It's not by might, it's not by power, but it's only by your Spirit, Spirit of the living God. Draw that one into the presence of the Most High God through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen and amen. Praise the name of the Lord. God is a good God. He loves you. And today, angels are rejoicing because you said, yes, I give the Lord my heart. Praise the Lord.
Here is my heart. I give it, Lord, to you. Here is my life, I lay it before you. Where else would I go? And what else would I do? If I did not know you, how deeply I need you.
How deeply I need you,
my Lord.
My Lord.
Oh, how deeply I,
how deeply I need you,
my Lord.
My Lord.
Like the desert needs the rain. Every
ocean needs the stream.
I need
you
like
every
morning
needs the sun.
I need
you, Lord. You are my only one.
Here is my heart. I give it, Lord, to you. And here is my life, I lay it before you. Tell me where else would I go?
Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Here is my heart. I give it all to you. Amen. And today, if you have given your heart to Jesus Christ, all of your heart, know that salvation is yours today. You know, get a King James Bible and start reading the Word of God. Talk to the Lord in prayer. His Word, he said, he shall always hear your cry. Amen. He said, the poor man cried and the Lord heard him and delivered him from all his troubles. Amen. The righteous cried. Now you're in right standing and you can cry to God. Psalm 34 speaks about this poor man and the righteous. So cry unto God. You have now an advocate. Salvation is yours. And ask the Lord to lead you to a Bible-believing, Holy Ghost-filled church that is led by the Holy Spirit. You know, he said we have not because we ask not. We cannot have the excuse that so many things are happening in terms of denominations and so much different mindset and man philosophies and say, okay, then, you know, I'm not going to go to church or not going to fellowship or what. God said, do not forsake the assembling of the saints, but ask God to lead you into all truths and he will direct your path. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
I do. If I did not know you.
Praise the name of the Lord. Last week on Wednesday, for those who listened in, you know, we still on the subject of faith. But today we're going to do it from a different perspective. But last week, just to recap, you know, I spoke on Genesis 26, where we saw that Isaac was given an inheritance from his father, wells. And in those days, I said that wells were like having a supply of provision for your cattle and for your livestock on the whole, and also for growth of plants so that your animals can be fed, and also for nourishment for yourself, what is essential. And, you know, he was in a land the way God had led him, and, you know, there was a famine, and he was taken care of in that place because he obeyed God. And, you know, to, you know, just break it down, he did not receive the wells that his father had left to him. This was something that he inherited. He was entitled to it, but he did not inherit it, because when his enemy saw that he had become very great and that he moved forward, you know, until he got so great, they became envious of him and they decided to put dust, soil, they blocked those wells. And it showed that Isaac did not stop because his enemies blocked him. He went on and, you know, had his servants dig about three times even to make sure that water came up so that his animals could be fed. He would just go to another spot until, you know, he would go dig another place. The enemy would come and do the same thing. You know, this is mine. When they blocked it, then they said, okay, then these wells are mine. They decide to repossess it, you know. So then Isaac moved away from them all. And the Lord visited him and said, listen, you know, do not be afraid. You know, I'm with you and I'm going to bless you. And Isaac, he moved away and his enemies came to that place. And when they came to that place, they said, we did not ask you to leave because we didn't do you anything. We didn't do you any wrong. Why did you leave? We know that God is with you. And then Isaac received them. He had a feast for them. You know, they celebrated with him. But then after they left the next morning, the servants came and said to him, this new place that we were digging to find water, we relocated. Yes. But we found water this morning. And this morning may you find water, the water of the Holy Spirit. That whatever you're looking for God to do for you, you have tried. You have tried several times. You feel that you don't have the strength to try again. Trust God at his word. Try another time. Isaac showed us by faith. He believed that water was under that ground. So he kept asking his servant to keep digging. Keep knocking. Keep seeking. Amen. Keep trying to find out if that there's your blessing on the other side. Amen. There's a blessing for you, but sometimes the blessing is on the other side, or the blessing is coming, but sometimes we're not located, we're not positioned, you know, so that we can receive. Amen. Sometimes the trials of life will bear you down. You might be in a job or in a situation where, even in a neighborhood where you figure that, you know, it's getting challenging, but you just keep trying. Keep saying, listen, you know, I'm going to do this, you know. I'm going to make it. There is some blessing. I am going to make it in this life. I'm going to make it to eternity. I'm going to make it with my children. I'm going to make it in this job. Sometimes our strength may grow weaker, but you must keep on trying like Isaac, because at the end, even we see his attitude, that those who were envious of him and tried to block him came and they celebrated with him. So there's, you know, just be patient. God is still working on your circumstances and your situation, but you must keep on doing the things that will lead you into victory. You are an overcomer, amen, and he wants you to overcome. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. Keep speaking his word. Keep testifying what he has done for you. Keep on thanking him for the things he have already done for you. Praise him, worship him, speak to him, and have an expectation that the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob will come through for you. Praise the name of the Lord. This was from Genesis chapter 26. Praise the name of the Lord. You can read, for those who did not get to hear the message, you can go into Genesis 26 and see how Abraham's faith propelled him into a place where even his enemies had to come and say, yes, God is with you. We didn't do you anything. God is truly with you. And God is with you this morning. You just got to know that and believe it and see him manifest himself to you. Praise the name of the Lord.
How deeply I need you,
my Lord.
Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. How deeply we need Lord, the Lord. Amen. We need him real deep these days. Amen. And we're going to this morning, I want to speak about the Protestant Reformation, but I'm going to just touch a little bit of it because, you know, it's a really deep topic. But I'm going to start by saying that persecution is going to come to the church. Amen. Persecution, yes, amen. We are going to have some persecution. Our faith will be tried. And God said, Jesus said, when I come back, will I still find faith on the earth? He didn't say, will I find law-abiding citizen? He didn't say he didn't say, when I come, will I find prosperity on the earth? He didn't come and say, when I come, will I find authority of the believer on the earth? He said, will I still find faith on the earth? So we have been on the topic of faith, and there's so much to faith, because this is what God is looking for. Jesus is looking for when he comes. Where is your faith? Has your faith walked away from you? Are you standing on the word of God? Are you following the true gospel of Jesus Christ? Are you living by man's rule or by God's precepts? These are the questions we have to ask. Am I still in the faith? Amen. Persecution is coming into the church. We see so many things are happening in Christendom that sometimes we don't see it on the news, mainstream news. But we see that, you know, in India, you know, in China, you know, in Africa, we see people are being burnt for the gospel. You know, they move away from maybe the religion that they knew can be, you know, Islam. And then they are, when they move out, you know, the family members will burn them or beat them to death, you know, torture them. And who are in the West, we still have an opportunity to enjoy the freedom of religion. And we need to take advantage of it and tell others that Jesus Christ is Lord and live the life of a believer. Persecution is coming to the church, yes. Jesus still, he said, will I still find faith on the earth? In Joshua, if you have your Bibles, praise the name of the Lord, you can turn to Joshua chapter 1, praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Joshua chapter 1. And we see that Joshua was going through some stuff because Moses was dead. And, you know, he was, you know, walking with Moses. They were en route to the promised land. And in the middle of that journey, you know, part of the journey, you know, then Moses died, you know. Moses was a servant of the Lord. And God spoke to Joshua and he says, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now therefore arise and go over this Jordan, thou and them, even to the children of Israel. Moses was dead, and God wanted him to rise up. And God wants you to rise up this morning and say, you know what? These situations, these things I'm mourning about, these are dead situations. God is not a dead God. He's a God who came that we may have life and have it more abundantly. He told Joshua to he wanted him to be strong in verse 6. He said, be strong and be of good courage, for unto this people thou wilt divide an inheritance, the land which I swear unto thy fathers to give them. Isaac did not receive the inheritance that was due to him by his father. But, you know, he was blessed and he received the promise that God have made to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, amen, Joseph, and all those that went after to the children of Israel. But he gave him an instruction, be strong and be of good courage. Verse 6. Then in verse 7, he went back and said, only be thou strong and be very courageous. Amen. And thou should observe to do according to all thy law. He wanted him to obey him. Amen. To be obedient. You know. Then in verse 9, he went on and he says to Joshua, have not I commanded thee? Be strong and be of good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed, for the Lord thy God is with thee wheresoever thou goest. God wants us to know that wherever we go, he is with us. But we must know that there's a beginning. We have a beginning with Christ. When we give our life to Christ and we say, yes, Jesus Christ is Lord, that's the beginning. But when we move from that confession, then we have to start living the life of a believer. But we must have the true living gospel. There are so many things that have taken place in the world, you know, from the time Christianity had been started, denomination started in the first century church. And Paul was, you know, talking about the division that divided the church. Division, he said, let them know that it was not of God. You know, the church today is very divided. God forewarned us that there would be a moving away, a shifting away from the New Testament pattern, you know, that he showed us concerning this gift of salvation and this gospel of Jesus Christ that he gave to the disciples and the apostles. He warns the Ephesians and the elders in Acts chapter 20, verse 28. Amen. If you have your Bibles, Acts chapter 20, praise the name of the Lord, and verse 28. I always say that when the scripture is being explained or read, get a pen, the paper, pencil, pen, whatever, something to write. Write the scripture down and go back and search it yourself. Because again, many false prophets and teachers are gone out into the world to possibly deceive the very elect. He said, take heed therefore, Acts 20, 20, take heed therefore unto yourself and to all the flocks over that which the Holy Ghost has made you overseers, to feed the church of God which he has purchased with his own blood. He is speaking to those who he has set as overseers in the church, those who are in leadership position, to make sure that we know, number one, that the Holy Spirit is the one who has made us overseers. Amen. The Holy Spirit who has made you, you know, to be the pastor, the bishop, the apostle, whatever leadership position, but to feed the church of God, amen, which he has purchased with his own blood. You did not buy the church. Jesus Christ's blood bought your salvation, and he bought this church that he's coming back for without spot or wrinkle. Now we have people having like a sort of ownership, you know, that, you know, I'm going to do what I choose to do because this is my ministry. Amen. God forewarned us there will be a shifting or moving away from the New Testament principle. We have to stay in tune. And Acts chapter 20, praise the name of the Lord, verse 29 and 30 says, for I know this, that after my departing shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flock. Also of your own selves shall men arise, speaking perverse things to draw away disciples after them. Paul was saying this. This is what's going to happen. Men will come and they will draw, you know, you out of that thing, that gospel that is given to you. So he was warning the early church, and he's warning us, the word of God is warning us today. When we go into Revelation, we see the model of the seven church of Asia Minor. And each one of us, you know, there is a church that represents that Asia Minor church. And as individuals, we are the church. We are the church. The Holy Spirit dwell in this temple. When you give your heart to Jesus Christ, you become the temple of the Holy Spirit, that he can dwell in you. So you have to ask yourself, what kind of temple is this Holy Spirit is dwelling in? He said, listen, you know, hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to the church. We have to self-examine. He said, speaking perverse things to draw away the disciples after themselves. Now we see, you know, even in the church now, in the modern day church, we see now, you know, there are some churches who are, you know, ordaining, you know, homosexuals even as ministers or marrying homosexuals, when the word of God clearly states that God is a holy God. You know, he does not tolerate sin. You know, he cannot stand in the face of sin. You know, he destroyed Israel. He destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah for these perverse practices that are becoming acceptable and, you know, so nations are embracing today. You know, where is God in the equation? Amen. Paul foretold of a departing from that will come. Yes, you know, everyone is saying that, okay, then I believe God. But when there is going to come a time when you have to say, yes, you know, this is what I believe. This is what I stand for. This is what my Bible says. This is what God expects from me. Are you going to be able to stand up for Jesus? He said, if you deny me, I'm going to deny you in front of men. Amen. If you deny me to the world, I'm going to deny you to my Father. Amen. On the first departure was without leadership and its organization. One of the first departure, there was that many departed. Amen. 1 Timothy 4 verse 1 and 3. Praise the name of the Lord. Let's go into this. 1 Timothy chapter 4. Praise the name of the Lord. God word, you know, we see so many things being fulfilled in this time. Amen. That we have to really take a step back and say, you know, where am I in all of this? Am I following the true gospel of Jesus Christ? Amen. Because of time, we may not be able to get into the topic, but I have to introduce the subject. If you continue to listen to Choice Gospel Radio on Wednesday, we'll go deeper into the Protestant, you know, Reformation. But I'm just bringing some things to our attention before we go into the topic. It says 1 Timothy 4, verse 1 to 3. 1 Timothy 4 verse 1 to 3 says, Paul, an apostle by the commandments of God our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ, which is our hope, unto Timothy my own son unto Timothy my son in the faith, grace, mercy and peace unto you from God our Father and Jesus Christ our Lord. As I sought thee to abide still at Ephesus when I came unto Macedonia, that thou might charge some that they teach no other doctrine. Amen. Verse 3. He said, as I besought thee to abide still at Ephesus when I went into Macedonia, that thou might charge some that they teach no other doctrine. Amen. Verse 4 said, neither give heed to fables and endless genealogies, which minister questions, rather than godly edifying, which is in faith. So do. God wants us to stay on point. Amen. He wants us to stay with the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. We don't go to believe a fable or some sort of new thinking because somebody said it, and this person you think has the answer to what you figure would fit your lifestyle. It says, some will depart from the faith, giving heed to deceiving, which is seducing spirits, and doctrines of demons. Amen. Speaking lies in hypocrisy, having their own conscience seared with a hot iron, forbidding to marry, and commanding to abstain from food which God created to receive with thanksgiving by those who believe and know the truth. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. We have to be careful. Amen. There is two sort of departure that will take place. Forbidden marriage, you know, not allowing to eat certain food he was talking about. We have different denominations And each denomination have different belief, different practices. Amen. Then we have many other smaller groups. You have so many different, you know, fragments of Christianity that came out. But God wants us to know that we have to get back to the gospel of Jesus Christ. Go back to the Word of God. Read the Word of God. See what happened in Acts chapter 2 when the disciples preached, when Peter stood and he preached to the people. 3,000 people were added to the church. They believed. They were pricked in their heart and they asked, what must we do to be saved? Amen. They wanted to know the answer. And the answer is to repent. The answer is to be baptized. The answer is to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. He told them what to do. Next week on Wednesday, we're going to look into the different reasons, the reason why, you know, there was a breaking away from after the original church, how the Catholic Church came into being and how they broke away from the Catholic Church into all the other religions and the different philosophies that came into being. But God wants you to know this morning that you have His Word. Amen. Get yourself a King James Version Bible. It's very close to the original Bible. There's so many different Bibles. But for you who wants the truth, stick with the King James Version. I always advise that. Read what happened in the book of Acts when they gave their life to Christ. Read the book, the Gospels. Start with John. John is about believing. See what God says in His Word and stick with the Word of God. Don't try all spirits. Don't just listen to what is being spoken to you. Go to the Word of God and search and hear what God is saying to you by His Spirit. Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, we say thank you for your word today, O God. Even, O God, Father, Lord God, as we try to understand, O God, the happenings of today, it's all in your word. Many false prophets and teachers, O God, Father, Lord God, will try to change your word. But your word is forever settled in heaven. May your people follow after the living and true gospel of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, for that one who do not know you as the Lord and Savior, I decree and I declare, now is the day of salvation. Receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, and we all shall come up higher in you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. May God bless you. May you search the scriptures yourself and receive the Holy Spirit as your teacher. The truth will be explained and downloaded to you by His power. God wants to save you and He wants you to have faith that when He comes, you will go home and reign with Him when He comes to rule in His 1,000-year rule and eventually take you back to His kingdom. God bless you. God keep you, make His face shine upon you, and give you peace. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. From Choice Gospel Radio, your life, your salvation, and your choice. God bless you.
Like the desert needs the rain.
Desert needs the rain.
I need to. And the ocean needs.